Yo, why does this remind me of the fucking Monsters, Inc. scene where they're all walking in slow motion, dude? I'm dead, bro. I mean, like, look at this. Like, you cannot tell me that this shit is not exact fucking similar, dude. I'm dead, bro. Right, so we're going to review the opening to Dragon Ball Collision X, a Xenoverse 2 RP. I'm just gonna review the opening, watch it. Gonna give my opinions on it. And yeah, it's gonna be some unfiltered stuff. I'm going to say what's on my mind, and I'm gonna be 100% honest about it. And yeah, I'm gonna talk about it, say what I think about it, and yeah, that's pretty much the sum of it. I haven't done one of these opening reviews in quite some time. I think the last one I did was, I want to say, Fighters Academy, but at the same time, it could have been Ascensions as well. One of those. It was the last one that I did, and that was like, I'm confident enough to say that it's been a year since then. If not, a little bit less, but I feel as though the year would be a case. But, anyways, let's get this started. Of course, I will, put in Jaito, the creator of this RP, his channel in the description below. Then feel free to check him out and view his content, see what you think, and yeah. So this is his first opening. I don't know if this is his first opening ever for an RP. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, but I believe this is the case. So go easy on him if you do not like his opening, but of course he has more openings than, you know. Now this he uploaded this on June 1st, 2019, so it's been pretty recent. The song is Blue Exorcist, opening one. So let's go ahead and check this thing out, shall we? Okay. First of all. Oh no. Oh no. 8 seconds in, dude, and I already see two characters that do not make me smile. I see Virus, and I don't know who the other guy is in the background, to be honest. Ellie? Eli? Eli, I'm gonna say, right? And then there's Vegiku. Oh no! I have not seen Vegiku in a fucking RP in quite some time. I think the last one I seen him in was in Saiyan Spirit. Z Star. Was literally it. And Virus is wearing the fucking Supreme Kai Zamasu, well, Supreme Kai Apprentice Zamasu's outfit. Like Sin, Veg, Ill. And like Raikkon from Z Star. He fucking wore that outfit too. That outfit is a curse. The outfit is a curse. Anybody who wears that, shame on you. Jaito, what are you wearing too? What is that? What is that fucking little cotton candy poo stick? What the fuck is that, buddy? Why are you wearing that? And Vegiku, I already know you would wear something stupid like that fucking. That fucking ugly ass Gohan tracksuit, only with a different color swap. What the fuck? Why though? Why do you need a. Why do you need to show that? Why couldn't you wear something else? Something even generic. I mean, granted, maybe wearing something that's not generic is better, but for this case, I would say no. Honestly, you should wear something generic. I mean, that's bad. That's just terrible. That outfit. Like, what were you thinking, buddy? Okay, so you. Okay, I'm just gonna tell you right now, the editing isn't that good. It's I mean, you tried at least. You tried, you know what I mean? Like you cut it. I guess, and you did what you could with it. That's pretty much all I gotta say about it. But the worst thing about this part is fucking Vegeku's pose. Like, what is that? What is that pose? Isn't that the fucking Zamasu pose? I hate that pose. That pose is terrible. Even more so now that fucking Vegeku uses it, and Daikon used it in Saiyan Spirit. It was pretty god awful. I'm talking about the first Saiyan Spirit. Not the first Saiyan Spirit, but like the second one, but the first opening to the second one. Anyone who uses that pose, no, stop, because it does look good on certain people, but on characters like Vegeku, Daikon, no, stop. Especially for Vegeku here, because this guy rolling up in a Gohan fucking tracksuit. No, that's just so bad. And then he got virus looking at the wars. There's Eli. Well, okay, so to be fair, Vegeku wasn't wearing a tracksuit in this little scene. He was more wearing the Super 17 top. The part that the thing that Kobayashi, Shadow, and Golden War, and I'm talking about Shadow from Saiyan Spirit. Was it that Shadow? Can't remember. There's so many shadows. But I think that was the case. If not, correct me if I'm wrong. But for sure, Kobayashi and Golden wore that in season 2 of Z-Star. And then the pants are okay, I guess. Look weird though, 'cause like he's just mixing and matching now. Oh my god, Vegeku, why? Okay, that was a little bit too dragged out. I get it, he was walking, right? But the others made it look so fucking awkward. They did not. I don't think they knew what they were doing. Like, if that was the case, it was incredibly obvious. I'm sorry. Like, Virus did not know what the fuck he was doing. You could tell. And Vegeku was walking in some different direction. Eli looked like he was coming over, but he was taking forever. It just looked so weird and odd. Okay, Vegeku just wrecked the shit out of Jado's character. RIP. Okay, you had Virus's character clashing with Janemba. And then you had some Frieza Race OC clashing with, who was that guy? I gotta go look back. Oh, Jaito. And then you have Turles. You know what? You see Janemba as a villain a lot. And the same could be said for yeah, well, I mean, yeah, I wouldn't say Turles because I rarely see Turles actually, so that's props. I rarely see Turles used in any RPs. I've seen him in one of the jank Saiyan Spirit episodes, but that wasn't really taken seriously, so I can't really say anything about that. But Janemba, he was used in Z Star and I would say he was used at Saint Spirit, one of the. He was in another one. He was in a movie. But like that was like a the Z Star version, just alternate reality dimension thing. But yeah, you got Vegeta clashing with Turles. Neat, I would say, I suppose. Jaito clashing again with Metal Cooler. Metal Cooler, I've seen him in fucking Z Star. So, eh, but that cooler didn't do anything at all. He didn't, I don't think he, yeah, he didn't really do anything really, so maybe he would be used better here. Okay, we got more Jaito walking. Now he's running. Now he's flying! And then we have a little photo editing mode on Share Factory thing. Looks nice for what it is. I think does Vegeku on the left side, bottom, top and bottom. And then Jaito in the middle, top and bottom. And then on the right, I don't know who the fuck that is. I want to say that's Virus's character. I don't know who the fuck that is. Correct me if I'm wrong. But yeah, overall, that picture looks decent. Looks decent. Looks decent. Like, some parts, or some of it is a little basic, generic. But most of it looks okay for what it is. And this is the first opening, so you can't really go crazy about it. You know what I mean? It's nothing shocking. But yeah, that's pretty much the opening right there. Yep, there it is. Oh, and at the end, you can see the fucking the Share Factory no video support clip, or I mean, image. You know when you trimmed it and you didn't trim it exactly the way you want to, like the music's longer than the clip itself. It shows up at the very end. That happened. It's okay though, cause if this was the first time using it, then okay, it makes sense. But and that mistake happens at times. So, but anyways, that's the opening itself. Now let's go ahead and talk about it. Now you've heard me add some comments into it. If I add some comments while I'm watching the damn opening or episode, which wouldn't be the episode because I can only record for so long. Opening wise, I had to. Majiku, Virus. No disrespect for them, to them personally. It's just most of the time their characters aren't used. Vision, I would say, because you got to put this into saying that every creator to an RP has a certain vision. They even though some may improvise, yes, and have their actors improvise, still, even if they'll deny it, it's a bullshit. Because I'll tell you right now, every creator has a vision, has a base vision. That's how the story continues and shit like that. I'm gonna tell you right now, a story cannot continue through pure improvise. That is not the case. That, anyone tells you that, they're bullshit, because they need something to base off of and continue, you know what I mean? And that's, how to reach an endpoint. If you can't find a vision, if you don't have one, I'm gonna tell you right now, there is no way you can finish an RP. You can dish out as many episodes as you can, but there will be no end game, because you don't know what you're doing. You're just improvising. You're just, saying, oh, I got this for this specific scenario. What happens after that scenario is finished? You're gonna be sitting there while everyone's waiting to record. You're gonna be like, all right guys, let's record. And then you go out there and there's nothing. There's like, but everyone has a vision. They have some sort of goal for each and every one of their characters, at least the relevant ones to them anyway, like major characters, I would say. But there are some actors that don't feel the same way. They may say they do, or they might try to throw an effort at times, but that isn't the case for certain characters or certain actors, I would say, depending, right? Because the actors may not say share the same vision you have as a creator. They might wanna be a little selfish and expect their character to be better or worse, depending on who that person is. It varies frequently in these RPs. And it's sad, but that is the case. But I'm not gonna go into that because that's not the purpose of this video. But I will say, Vegeku and Virus, they do have a little habit of changing their character for the way they envisioned it, rather than listen to the creator. And if they don't like what they want to hear, they like if that if the creator tells them something they don't like for their character, they're just not gonna put any effort into it at all. They're just gonna eventually give up and leave or do something hectic. And that's what worries me, because I'm not gonna lie, even Virus Magic, they can be a little controversial, you know what I mean? At least in the case of off screen wise, for their characters or whatever's going on in the RP that they're in. So it kind of scares me when I see them appear in somebody else's RP. I'm not gonna lie, because usually things don't end in a good way for them, their characters, and the creators themselves. And this was kind of present in Collision X, because nowadays you do not see Virus nor Vegeku, their characters nor themselves, appear on Jaito's channel, because something had to ha something happened, obviously. So that's even more supports what I'm saying here. But yeah, so that's why seeing them kind of made me cringe and get all like, oh no, you know what I mean? So yeah, now that one's out of the, that part's out of the way. I would say the editing, I've already said this, the editing is it's very underwhelming, I would say. But if this is the first time being edited, like using Share Factory, Jaito, then okay, get a pass, brother. You know what I mean? Because I was basic as shit when I fucking used Share Factory too, just to a different extent. But still, it's understandable, 100%. Music's okay. It kind of feels a little off. I don't know why. It felt like, I don't know what you're doing, like were you recording through your phone or something? I don't know. Because Virus had the same issue. I don't know what he was doing either. But maybe you just don't have a computer or laptop that you can, you know, save files from, and then, you know, like a flash drive that I use. So if you don't have a flash drive, then okay, 100% understandable, because you need an opening. Even if you have to record through your phone, you have no other choice, then okay, you get another pass for that. Because I would have done the same thing, you know? What kind of fucking RP doesn't have an opening, you know what I mean? Well, for Xenoverse, anyways. Like an anime type thing. But, anyways. Yeah, the characters, Virus HQ, I am not sold on. They look atrocious. I'm sorry. Jaito looks. He looks okay. Looks okay. I'll give him that. The other character, the demon thing, the Freezer Race demon guy, I don't know what his name is. His name wasn't mentioned. He looks okay, I suppose. Nothing more, nothing less. That's it. That's all I got for him. Who else? If I'm missing anybody else, then I'm sorry. It just didn't really seem like a character that I was interested in, nor hated. You know what I mean? They were just there. If I skipped past them, I'm sorry. But yeah, the character. But it was okay. It was the first opening, of course, so you can't expect too much. But yeah, it was okay. I'm looking forward to, you know, doing the other openings. I will review the first three episodes in one, when I get the chance. So stay on the lookout for that. And yeah, just this is what, like, I will give out of 10. I will give this opening a 1 out of 10. 1 out of 10. I'd say that's pretty fair. Only for the music. The music was very, like, at first I was like, eh, I wasn't sold on it. But then as it progressed, I was like, okay, it's not bad of an opening. It's not, you know, something I'd remember, but it's okay, in my opinion. But yeah, that's about it. All I have for this opening review. And yeah, I'm gonna let you guys watch it and see for yourselves. So.
I'm not playing anymore.
Whoa, wait, what'd you see?
I don't know. I don't want to know. I'm out.